Hi, aspiring writers, writing coach Stefanie Newell, and this is the Life of a Writer channel. Today's video, how to format your ebook for Kindle. So if you want to connect with readers and sell more books, make sure to subscribe and get new content to your subscription page every Tuesday. But in this video, I'm going to be sharing a highly requested video on how to format your ebook for Kindle. Now, this is one of those videos that you guys have been asking me for a really long time, and I've been hearing you, but the reason why I hadn't done it was because I was looking for a simple method that everyone could understand. And I have been recently using Amazon's Kindle Create, which is a simple software that allows you to convert your document into a Kindle file that you can upload and publish to Amazon. So in this video, I'm going to be moving over to my computer and I'm going to be doing a tutorial that will walk you through the steps for converting your Microsoft Word document or your Google document into a Kindle file that you can publish to Amazon. So let's move over to my computer. So the first thing that you're going to want to do is download this formatting tool, Kindle Create. Now this is going to be on Amazon's website, and of course I'll put the link in the description box so you'll know exactly where to get it. Once you have this downloaded to your computer, you want to open it, and it's going to give you two options. The first option is to resume an existing project. The second option is to open a new project from file. So because this is the first time we're working on a project, we're going to select the new project from file option. Once that is open, you'll see on the left-hand side, there are a couple of different options. So you're going to select the type of book you're making. For example, if you're doing a novel, an essay, a poetry book, a narrative nonfiction, comics, or a textbook, or even cookbooks, you have a lot of different options. What Kindle Create is going to do is going to take your file and it's going to auto-identify the chapters within your book. It's going to format it quickly by identifying common elements. And so the first thing we're going to do is choose a file. I don't have a project that I'm currently working on, so I'm just going to use an old college paper that I did a long time ago, and I'm going to import that into this document. What you'll see it doing is going through and recognizing all of those different styles, chapters, subtitles, and once it opens, you will see what happens. And the first thing you'll notice over here on the left-hand side is a lot of suggested chapter titles. Now, because this is a college paper and it doesn't actually have titles throughout it, I'm going to reject all of mine. But if you were to do this, you may have actual titles, and so you can either select them all, or you can select some, or you can reject them all. In my particular case, I am going to reject them. The first thing that I'm going to do is go to the right-hand side and click Themes, and this will show you some of the different themes that you can select. So here's a classic, Cosmos, Armor, I believe that is, but we're going to go with Modern because that's the first one that shows up. So all you have to do is select your title and then go over here to the right and click Chapter Title, and that will apply that element. I'm going to select the prologue and choose that as my subtitle. And then this first paragraph, I'm going to apply this element, chapter first paragraph, and it will give it a first paragraph element. So as you can see, guys, it is a very simple process. There are a lot of different elements. Down here on the right-hand side, you see this section where it says title pages. So if this were your title page, you could go in and put in different elements for your title, your subtitle, your author name. Also, if you were doing a poem, there's elements for that, as well as for opening quote or dedication or copyright text. There's also formatting changes that you can do, such as bolding, italics, or underline. Again, it's a very simple process. So up here at the top, I'm going to click Preview. And what this is going to do is going to show you exactly how it will look on a device. So right now we're looking at how it will look on a tablet, but I can choose phone. I can also choose a Kindle e-reader, and basically what this is going to do is give you an idea of what it will look like. I'm going to go up to File and make sure you are saving your project. You definitely want to make sure that you're saving your project. So you just want to go in periodically while you're working on formatting your project, and you want to go in and save from time to time. That's going to be important, guys, so that you don't lose any of the changes that you've made. I also want to show you one more thing. If you go up here to the left-hand side and click Insert, it will allow you to insert an image into your document or even a table of contents if that wasn't already created in the initial stages. So once that's done, you want to click Publish, and this is going to export your Kindle Create ebook to publish to Kindle. Again, this is going to save your project,
And once it's saved, it's going to show you a KPF folder, which you can take that file, and now your file is ready to publish.
So now that you have a converted file and you're ready to upload your book to Amazon, make sure you grab a copy of my free PDF, 5 Things You Must Know Before Uploading Your Book to Amazon. As always, all of my social media links will be in the description box below. If you're looking to hire me as your writing coach, you will find that information there as well. And I look forward to talking with you in my next video.